I'm going to show you how to set up single sign-on to Workplace from Facebook using Azure Active Directory. It only takes a few minutes. Let's jump into it. Okay, to set this up, it's really easy. On the left side, we're going to log into Azure Active Directory. Within the portal, we're going to go to Enterprise Applications and click on New Application. And we're going to add an app from the gallery. So I'm just going to type in Workplace. And I click on Workplace from Facebook, click Add, and away I go. Now, I've already done this in my environment. And so here's my enterprise app, Workplace, and I'm going to click on single sign-on. And then here is my SSO configuration. So I'm going to click on basic SAML configuration. And then now on the right side, I'm signed into Workplace. I've enabled SSO under the admin panel and under security and the authentication tab. I've enabled SSO, set SSO as a default for new users. I haven't removed password yet. I'll talk about why later on. And then I've added my email domain, sospin.org. Now I've already set up SSO, so I'm gonna edit my preferences. I'm gonna show you what I did. So down here under SAML configurations, we basically just do a copy and paste. So audience URL goes into the identifier field here in Azure AD. Recipient URL goes into the sign-on URL field. And then ACS URL goes into the ACS URL field here. And when I'm done, I just click save. Now, once I've done that, I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to first download the certificate here from Azure, and then I'm going to copy it and paste it into the Workplace admin panel, like you could see here. Once I do that, then I'm going to go back to Azure here, click on configuration URLs, and I'm going to start doing copy and paste. Login URL, you're going to copy that and paste it to SAML URL. Azure AD identifier, copy that and paste it to issuer URL, and then logout URL, paste it here to the logout URL. And at that point, go ahead and make sure you save your changes in Azure, and then over here, click Test SSO, and it's going to launch a new window, and it's gonna test single sign-on. So here we can see it's working. So perfect, we are ready to rock and roll and do some more testing. So now that I have all this set up, back in the Azure portal here, I'm gonna go back to Workplace by Facebook, and I'm gonna click on Users and Groups. And this is where I tell the system who to allow access to this app. So I'm gonna allow Megan access, but also anybody that's in the Workplace Access group, okay? Now, I'm gonna talk about user provisioning in another video, but this is the basic way to set up single sign-on. Now, to fully test this, I'm gonna go to myapps.microsoft.com. And this is our application portal for Megan, our end user. And when she signs into myapps.microsoft.com, down at the bottom, there's Workplace from Facebook. And when she launches that, it's going to open a new tab and it's going to launch Workplace from Facebook. And there you have it. So another way to do this is let's open up a new in private window and let's browse out to sospin.workplace.com, our custom URL. We're going to sign in. And then it's going to redirect us to Azure AD, like so. We're going to sign in and zoom in for you a little bit so you can see what we're doing. And once we're signed in, it's going to log us into Workplace. And there we go. And now we're ready to rock and roll. So as you can see, this is super easy to set up. To verify your email domain, you have to go to Settings. And then within Settings, go to Email Domains. And there's a number of different ways you can verify it. One of the ways is just creating a text record in DNS. That's how I did it. And then back under security and authentication, I have it set up as an assigned email domain. I turned off SAML reauthentication, although you could enable it. And I've turned off allow everyone to log in to supported products. I'll come back later and disable passwords. I'm not quite ready for that. And I'll talk about why in the provisioning video coming up next. So folks, this is how you enable single sign-on in Azure Active Directory. Hope you enjoyed this video. I'll go ahead and post this out there. So if you have any questions, let me know and we'll see you in the next video. Take care.